Hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. And today I'm in Royal Forest again, and actually almost the same spot as last time, what I could call the dream forest. It's very nice to be here. The only thing that's bothering me is the mountain bikers that are coming out on the track here in the forest. So I moved a little bit further away from that. So I hope I can be here without being disturbed. And I've opened a beer, Duvel, I think it's called. One of my subscribers, a man called Pascal from Belgium, sent me some Belgian beer and some chocolates, and they are so great. And the chocolate, oh, it's nice. So thank you for that, Pascal. I appreciate that very much. Skål. And together with my beer, I eat some beef jerky. This is not something that are very often sold in Denmark. I have never seen it in plain, ordinary shops. So perhaps in special places we can buy this, but I never tasted it before. So when two of my great subscribers, Becky and Peter, from Mississippi in the USA, they have sent me a whole lot of stuff from their hometown. And I show you in the picture here, there's all kind of stuff in that. So I'm very grateful for that. And I even got some whiskey for my coffee. And I pour it into my little flask. And it's, of course, it's Jack Daniel's whiskey from the United States of America. I love it. It's one of my favorites. So thank you very much, Becky and Pete, from your kindness. And well, I'm out of words. I really enjoy this, and I will enjoy all the things that you sent me. They are all good, and even the small package of oatmeal, we can't get it here in Denmark, so I'm looking forward when I'm making an overnighter, I will use that for breakfast. So thank you very much. I'm just sitting here enjoying the nature. And as you can see, a little bit of sunshine is coming. It's awesome, it's nice. And well, the winter hasn't come yet. We had frost this night, so there's a little frost around, but no snow. I'm waiting for that. And I have to be careful not to wish it too much, because when we got a lot of snow, I have a long driveway from the road to my house that I have to move by hand. And every time it snows heavily, I curse it very much, because it's very hard work, and you all know that. But anyhow, a little bit of snow could be nice, a little bit of white overall. It lightens up here in the dark month of the year. It is so nice. Skål. Well, have you noticed my new bracelet? I love it. And it's a company in France that make these. Of course, I put a link below so you can find it. And it's very awesome, because this company is offering 20% in discount for all my subscribers and all my viewers. You just have to write Cimbrer, and then you get 20% off. So it's an awesome deal for all of you. And I recommend you to go into their website and see what they have to show you. It's very different things they have. They have necklaces and bracelets and rings and so on. Very great, and a very great product they use. This one is made of leather and bronze. A real Viking jewelry, and I like it very much. Got an amber here. Can you see it? Yeah, right there. You can see the smoke. You just have to blow it in this tinsel bundle. There it was. Some of my subscribers have asked me if I would like to show you how I make my cowboy coffee. And I'll do that. First, I put water over, and when it's beginning to be warm, before it boils, I put the coffee in. And this coffee is coarse grind coffee, the same you use for the pressing coffee. I don't know if you use that everywhere, but it's coarse grain coffee, and in here I have approximately 300 to 400 centiliters water, and then I come 1, 2, and 3.5 spoon of coffee in, and I can put the lid on now, but I have to be careful because when this begins to boil, the coffee will boil over if you're not careful. So I have to watch the coffee and see when it's beginning to boil. Now let's see, yeah. Did you see that? I have to be careful. And now it's beginning to boil, and I lift it so that the heat is not so strong. After a minute, I take it off, and I put a little cold water in it. Just a bit. And the reason why I do this is because when the cold water hits the coffee, the grains will sink to the bottom. So the grains won't be in my cup. And now I can put the lid on again and wait for it to cool down. And And now for the most important thing in my cup of coffee. Well, the whiskey. Oh, that's nice. Ah. And thank you so much, Becky and Pete from Mississippi, for supplying me with whiskey. I really appreciate that. And the American whiskey, Jack Daniels, is one of my favorites too. So thank you very much. Well, some of you have maybe had noticed that I got me a new axe, or hatchet, as they say in English, a little axe. And well, I'll tell you about this little axe in my next episode. And actually, next weekend, if the weather is okay, I'm going out to my new camp, my base camp, and start preparing so that I can set my tent up and make my fireplace. I'm very excited for that. So if everything goes as I planned, next weekend it will be about clearing the area where I'm going to have my camp. So I'm looking forward to that, and I hope you too. You do too. I think it's going to be a very amazing place and a very cool place I can practice my bushcraft skill in. I'm really looking forward to that. Now I'm just finished my coffee, and soon I'll be heading home, editing this video. Thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft, and I hope you like this little video, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye, and take care.